Okay, good morning, welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us in today's International Igniting Mind lecture. My name is Vaibhav Jain and I am the program leader, Department of Computer Science and Engineering at School of Engineering and Technology, Jagran Lake City University, Bhopal. The Igniting Mind lecture series segment at Jagran Lake City University is a unique initiative to strengthen the knowledge of our students in various emerging fields. This time, JLU is celebrating the Global Teaching Month with 30 plus international faculties from 12 countries through the special series called International Igniting Mind Lecture Series 2020. In the same row, today, JLU School of Engineering and Technology is organizing an International Igniting Mind Lecture titled Wireless Data Transmission Using Latest Technology. To deliver this lecture, we are having our special guest in between us, Dr. D. Balaganesan, who is the Dean, Faculty of Computer Science and Multimedia, Lincoln University College, Malaysia. Before proceeding further, let me introduce our guest speaker for today. Dr. D. Balaganesan is the Dean of Faculty, Computer Science and Multimedia, Lincoln University College, Malaysia. He is one of the key members of Lincoln University College. He has 18 plus years of professional teaching experience, which include overseas experience in India, Oman, and Malaysia. He has in-depth knowledge of information technology and latest wireless technology. He has been the resource person for various training programs, including open source ERP, software testing, and MySQL. He has developed computer software applications like timetable automation, online exam, and published the book Computer Application in Business. He has been actively involved in various professional bodies, such as elected member in Michigan Association for Computer Users in Learning, USA, member in International Association of Engineers, Hong Kong, member in Institute for Engineering Research and Publication, member in Computer Science Teacher Association, New York, and many more. He serves as editor board member, technical committee, reviewer of various reputed international journals. He also serves as international committee member towards international conferences conducted in association of reputed organizations like Springer and Scopus. Sir, on behalf of JLU School of Engineering and Technology, we welcome you. Now, I would request to Dr. Dilip Kumar Singh, sir, Head JLU School of Engineering and Technology, to please welcome our guest speaker for today, Dr. D. Balaganesan, and sir, also enlighten us with your inspirational words. Sir, please.
Yeah, thank you, Vaibhav. A very good morning and warm welcome to all the participants joining today's International Igniting Mind lecture on wireless data transmission using latest technologies, which is the part of the JLU International Igniting Mind lecture series. It's my great pleasure to welcome our expert of this session, the very phenomenal and dynamic Professor Dr. D. Balaganesh, Dean Faculty of Computer Science and Multimedia, Lincoln University College, Malaysia. We are very thankful to you, sir, for taking time out and being here with us for igniting our young minds. I must take this opportunity to briefly introduce the university and JLU School of Engineering and Technology to our esteemed expert. So we are the most awarded university in Central India, having plenty of partnership with top industries and international universities, and has been awarded with several prestigious awards. Mentioning few of them, such as University of the Year by Government of Madhya Pradesh, recognized as a Global League Institute at the House of Commons, London, UK, ranked number one university in Madhya Pradesh by several leading publications. At JLU, our motto is igniting mind, changing lives. And that's what we always are trying to do. And this series reflects. If I talk particularly about JLU School of Engineering and Technology, considering the industry needs, we introduced two widely popular specializations under our BTech Computer Science and Engineering and BCA programs. One is Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning, and another one is the User Experience. And collaborated with various renowned industries and the international universities as our knowledge partner. We are a part of the international project called Tuning India, funded by European Union, and also working on the various government-funded projects. Our focus is on project-based learning, and so we even provide a financial grant to our students to promote and support their innovation and their patents. And I can proudly share that recently, a team of our students won rupees 1 lakh as a first winning prize in the Smart India Hackathon from the Government of India. So moving further, without delay, once again, I'll take this opportunity to heartily welcome our esteemed expert, Professor Dr. D. Bala Ganesh, and hand over to him to enlighten our students on wireless data transmission using latest technologies. So please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Vaibhav, and thank you, Dr. Dilip Singh, sir. And give this opportunity, Professor Divakar Shukla. Thank you, all of you. Nice to meet and nice to, this is the kind of situation to share our knowledge with like this kind of way. So it's really good for us. Earlier, we are not doing such kind of things, but nowadays, if the COVID is given some positive approach to all, so we can share this kind of thing. Earlier, we are not trying much like this, but nowadays we are trying many of these kind of webinar and seminars, online conference, online international conference on all these things. So it's really helpful for all the sharing the knowledge all over the world. And it's very easy to share the knowledge. So it's no need to follow the any protocols, need to do this thing, and the person need to come that place. And we need to organize the accommodations and all these things. So earlier days, it's a very big headache for doing all these things. But nowadays, frequently, we are doing this kind of thing. It's really helpful. The COVID is affected more, but this is the one kind of positive thing we get it from due to the COVID. We can share our knowledge like this. Wherever we are, we can share it. Whatever the things, we can share the knowledge and all these things. So it's really good for us. Thank you for that. Okay, so I am Bala Ganesh. It's a dean of Lincoln University College. First of all, I would like to thank to the management to allow to share this kind of knowledges. So thank for the management and then organizing team members, Vaibhav and who are all the colleagues get involved in that organizing committee and all these things. Thank you for that. It's a great support. To sharing this kind of knowledge is really helpful. Thanks for Dr. Dilip Singh. They done a good job for us, continuously sending message and making this thing is properly to do. Thank you, Dr. Dilip sir. And when the first thing it's happened is based on the Professor Divakar Shukla. Professor, thank you, Professor Divakar Shukla. Thanks for that. So let's start our presentations, our seminar. Thank you all. Okay, I can share my PPT. Can you see my screen? Can you all see my screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We are able to see you.
Okay. Thank you. So my audio is audible?
Yes, sir. You are clearly audible.
Okay. Thank you. So let's start that. So it's a wireless data transmission using latest technology. So first of all, just what I started that, the same thing I will enhance some more things with that, what I mentioned that. Like earlier days, these kind of webinars, seminars, and all these things, it's very difficult. It's not a, not we are not having that idea. The problem is high bandwidth, the high internet connections. In a, if you think about in the 1990, that period, it's our data transmission speed, that is our internet speed is just, it's 1.2 KB per second. Later, it's happened in 2020, it's around 56 KBPS like that. Then 2000. Then 2008, it goes to MBPS speed, like 5 MBPS speed and 10 like the 10 MBPS speed. Like nowadays, we are using 100 MBPS speed. We are fully satisfied with the high speed of data transmissions. But from our age, it's okay. Our generation is okay. But the other younger generations, still they are not satisfied with that internet speed. Still they need high-level data transmissions. High-level bandwidth they need. So that is a thing. So the latter, which technology I'm going to explain today, if we use this technology, it could be possible to transfer per second. Per second, you can transfer minimum 20 to 30 GB per second. So that is a technology I'm going to tell today. So using this wireless data transmissions, so without wire, the data transmission, you can possible to transfer minimum 20 to 30 GB per second. It's really helpful to do these kind of seminars, animations, games, tutorial, to taking the tutorial with the graphics and animations on virtual platform. So all these things, it's really helpful. So that is the things we are going to see today in that latest technology of wireless data transmissions. So before going to speak, so normally what we will think, if in the new technology is coming, automatically it should be cost-wise, it's so high. But then the structure, framing the structure, it's very difficult. And that particular component is not available in market. It takes time to get it in the marketplace. So these are the problems we will face. If whatever the latest technology is coming, it takes time, minimum 5 to 10 years like that. But I'm sure this latest technology, no need any latest equipment or anything. Just we can easy to get this thing, easy to available everywhere. To use this thing, you can make it the high data transmission. So that is an advantage of this wireless latest technology for high data transmission speed. Okay, so what the things we are going to do? So before going to explain this, sharing this thing about the latest technology, first I want to explain some our traditional internet connections, traditional networking systems, what we are following. Why everybody know all are well experienced on a traditional networking system. So why I'm going to explain that a traditional method means, if we know some of the drawbacks from that traditional method, so what are the drawbacks is there? So what are the things we need to do? What is the difficulties we are facing? All these things, if we know, then we can easy to understand what are the high level benefit with this latest technology. So that is the reason. First, I'm going to that our traditional transmission method, all these things. Then I will go to that latest technology. So what are the things I need to cover from this thing? So first, I need to tell about that types of data transmission. Then next, I want to tell about that what are the components we need for transferring the data, like message receivers and like that. So what are the components it's need? So that is the thing. I just give some introductions, and this, without that we cannot. So that is a traditional network systems we are following. So that one I can tell. Then types of network, everybody know that. That one just is a topic I just covered. Then I will go to that types of network, then types of topologies, what are the kinds of topology normally we are using. Then what are the internet service providers, we are kind of the internet service provider is available and how it's benefitable. Then what are the networking concept we are using until now. So this is the thing, these are all the things I just covered. Then I will go to that latest technology. Okay, so this is the thing is today I'm going to cover. That one is basic data transmission system, component of data transmission, then three types of networks, network topology, network concept, then internet service, then communication media, then I will go to the latest technology. Okay, so the first thing, basic data transmission system. So normally the data transmission system, we can split it in two types. One is serial data transmission, another one is a parallel data transmission. So the serial data transmission, it's one by one, each one bit by bit it's possible to transfer, but parallel transmission, n bit can possible to transfer. But what is the advantage and disadvantage? I mean, serial data transmission, it's covered a long distance, but parallel data transmission, it's not covered a long distance, it's covered only the short distance. So this is the some of the drawback in the traditional methods we are using. So that's why I want to tell this thing. So like basic data transmission having a parallel with the serial. So the serial method, serial having one bit and this one is n bit, then one line, single line, it's a n line. It's very slow, that one is faster compared to that serial level, but higher line, and also that cost wise, the coverage wise, it's covered very short distance, and it's covered that serial level, it's covered that long distance. So this is the basic data transmission. Okay, whatever it is, if you want to transfer the data, what all the thing is important, means you need a sender, receiver, messenger, and the medium, which medium you are going to transfer. And another thing, another important thing is about the protocols. So without these things, you cannot possible to transfer. That is a traditional method we are following. Yeah, component of data transmission, message, sender, receiver, transmission medium, and protocols. So without that, we cannot. So we need to follow the certain protocols. Without the protocols, we cannot make it. So we follow the protocols. So from the latest technology which I'm going to explain, no need any specific medium. It's not necessary the specific medium. So that is an advantage. And protocol also, it's not many protocols to use. So that is an advantage. I'm going to explain that latest technology. Then the types of network, all the students and everybody know nowadays, everybody know that LAN, WAN, MAN. So these are the type of networks we are using. So it's differ from single group, multi-level group, n number of groups, based on that it's differ. So this way, this is common, everybody know this thing. So I don't want to take much time. Then I goes to that network topology, like the formation, what kind of topologies we are going to follow, and which is very friendly, which is for which sectors it's very benefitable. Like the star topology means banking sectors is very available, ring topology, browsing center and all, bus topology, particularly education sectors, we are using that the bus topology, hierarchical aisle and mesh topology, the software field, it's really helpful for this kind of topology. So this is a kind of traditional methods we are using, the types of topologies. Okay, so this is the network topologies, we everybody know that. Then networking concept, we always, if we want to do that networking, sharing the information and all these things, we should know the basic thing, basic concept of these all the things. Protocols, that is a set of rules, so we need to know about what is the protocols, what kind of rules we need to frame, fix it, configure, all these things we need to know. Then the TCP IP, that is internet protocols, and that one is a packet, how the data is segregated like a packet and how they make it a sequence, all this thing is based on the TCP IP. And switches, it's just connecting all the resources, whatever the devices you want to connect, all the resources you want to connect, you can use that switches. Then the routers, you can connect many switches, and routers, the main thing is how efficient to find the route to transfer the data. So that is a router. We are normally we need to know. Then client server model, so client and server technology, so which one is server, how many client is possible to connect, and what kind of client server model we are going to use. These are all the things. Apart from this thing, one more important thing is bandwidth. We have a high internet connection speed, but bandwidth is very poor, means no use. So the bandwidth also very much important. So high bandwidth we need, then only you can transfer your data proper manner. So that is a major networking concepts we need to know in the traditional methods. Okay, then types of internet services, there is a lot kind of different kind of services are there. Digital subscriber line, broadband line is there, fiber optic broadband connections, that one also you can use, Wi-Fi use, and WiMAX also we are using, wireless fidelity and worldwide interoperability, microwave access, WiMAX we are using, then satellite and mobile broadband, that one we are using CDMA and GSM, co-divisible multiple access, and global system for mobile communication. So all these kind of things, the traditional methods we are following. So this is the type of internet services we are using. Okay, now the types of communication media. So what the things we are using in that types of communications media? So the types of communication media, we can split it like two types. One is wire and wireless. So what is the under that wired medium? So we have that electrical level and the light level. So we already used the light conductor also in that wired method. Okay, so from that electrical, again we can segregate like wireless, then that is STP and UDP, then coaxial cable, then light based one is a fiber optical. Then wireless one, we are using that radio frequency, light frequency. So under the light frequency, we already used that infrared, then radio frequency having a lot of things like broadcast, speed spectrum, cellular, microwave, and satellite. So all these things. So these are the types of communication medium we are using. So what I'm going to tell, what is the technology I'm going to explain now, that one is under this category of wireless, under this category of light frequency, but apart from infrared, there is other technology we are going to use. That one, what I want to, before I'm going to show that latest technology, one more thing I need to highlight, that one is not exactly that latest trend, that one is during the year of 1880, Graham Bell is invented for communication medium. First he tried around February, I think, he invented the method, the way you can communicate through the light. So light can transfer the data. So that is a thing, it's the year of 1880 itself, Graham Bell is invented, but some of the reason he stopped that research in further, then he goes to that wired based technology. So what the technology he already mentioned, the same thing nowadays it's getting popular, surely within 5 years it's good to, it's good, it would be a big it will cover that big, all the sectors in the internet level, all the sectors it's covered, and the maximum transmission possible very easy using this technology. So that is a thing, that is a technology I'm going to tell now, that is Li-Fi technology. Li-Fi, light fidelity. So through the light, you can transfer the data. So Li-Fi is coined by Professor Harold Haas during the TED Global Talk. So that is a bi-directional. So that is earlier it's a single directional, then nowadays it's a bidirectional also, it's possible. So high speed and fully networked wireless communications. So it's almost like a Wi-Fi, but compared to that transmission speed, compared to that, it's more than 300% high speed compared to that Wi-Fi. So that is a technology we are going to see, that is a Li-Fi, light fidelity. So light can transfer the data. Light can access the internet through the light. So the light is in LED light. Just you can use that LED light to do the some connections with that network. Then through the light, you can access the internet. It's really, really good thing. So it's available in everywhere. You can get it, your internet, in our street light, in our vehicle, whatever vehicle we are having, two-wheeler or four-wheeler, from that light also we can get it, and even that flight from that light also we can access that internet. That one is not in the minimum level, it's a maximum high speed internet you can access. So that is a benefit of Li-Fi. And other one more thing is medical sector also, it's really helpful in many area. And also one more thing I want to highlight, that is underwater. Underwater internet connection is very difficult, but if you use this Li-Fi, so you can do that underwater connections. Underwater also you can get that internet connections, data transmission, message transmission, and all this thing is possible. So it's that is a Li-Fi technology. So next, what is the thing? What is the advantage is there compared to all other whatever the traditional methods we are talking, compared to all the traditional methods, this one is high capacity, high efficiency, high availability, more security. So these are all the area it's fully covered. And one more thing I need to highlight, it's very economic. Cost price also, it's very less. So that is a thing, it's very effective. So that's why we can use this Li-Fi technology. We can do many research on this area. So this is the ongoing process. So if we start that any research on this area, it's really helpful for to the all over the world. It's really helpful and really help for the students to do many such kind of research work. Okay, so what kind of the visible spectrum? So the light means it's visible. So where it's visible, it's a visible spectrum. You can access your internet from the visible spectrum. But I already told you that it's cover long distance also. But how can it cover that long distance? LED, it's not cover the long distance. Compared to Wi-Fi, it's also it's cover that very less distance. That's a thing we can update, we can enhance another method. Instead of using LED, we can use laser light. So we can use that laser light, it's cover the distance. You everybody know that how much it's cover the distance. You can transfer there from space to earth. You can transfer your data from space to earth through via laser light. So that kind of benefit is that via this laser light, via this laser light beam, you can transfer your data. It's not a shortest distance, it's cover the long distance to transfer and point that exact people to whom you want to transfer. You can exactly transfer that person. So there is no other option to hacking and all these things, because if any other person is getting, means they need that beam. So without the beam, they cannot access. So it's very secured one. So that is the another enhancement of that Li-Fi. So light light fidelity, instead of using LED, we can use that laser light. You can transfer long distance to high speed data transmission. It's possible. So that is a very important thing in Li-Fi. Okay, just there is a comparison between Li-Fi and Wi-Fi. So what is the comparisons? If any new technology, it should be the cost wise, it's very high, and framing and structure framing, it's very difficult, and the range and all these details, you can get it from this. So the security wise, it's Wi-Fi can possible to hack, but Li-Fi cannot possible to hack, because it's a light, it's a visible spectrum. So if anyone is try to hack, we can access, we can easily to visible, it's visible, so we can stop it. Then data transmission is slower, this is much faster. Then range, it's a small range, it's covered the large range. Then traffic control, so it's more due to that high speed and easy availability. So the traffic control, there is no such thing, no traffic will happen in that Li-Fi. Then where can be used? So we can use LAN like that. So wide area LAN, local area network, and so these are types of networks. And we already mentioned that in the traditional methods, we follow that land, van, man, like that. But this Li-Fi, anywhere we can use it. So that is a main thing. Then the sixth point, it's very, very important one, cost. Wi-Fi, compared to Li-Fi, Wi-Fi is costly. Li-Fi is very, very cheap, light fidelity. So the working concept is various topologies we need, but here, direct binary data serving. So no need to worry about this topology, that topology. So specifically one thing we need to follow, you can access the data and high speed transmissions, you can get it. So that is a main advantages also. So that is a difference between Li-Fi and Wi-Fi. Okay, there's a difference and all these things. So how I can do that is like a mini, the students having a doubt. So how can I do this Li-Fi project and how, what are all the things I need and how I can transfer that high speed data? How I want to check it means there is a lot of mini projects are available in YouTube and Google and everywhere it's available. So many Li-Fi project is available, but implementation is not much happen. So this is the right time for all the students and the researchers to do more research on this area. Then within a 5 years, most of your paper and the research thing and most of the things you will get a grant on this area. So it's a right time to do the research on this. So how it is working? From that internet, then I connect that LED. Then there is a photo detector. So the photo detector is receiving the light, then transferring to the system, and you can access the computer. So then the student will ask, sir, where can I get the photo detector? And LED is okay. Then how can I get the photo detector? And what are the process I want to do that? It's a simple project you are telling, and the photo detector, it's difficult to get it and all this thing. No worry about the photo detector. Instead of photo detector, you can use another way that is called solar panel. So I already enhanced the two things. Instead of LED, you can use laser light. Instead of photo detector, you can use solar panel. So the solar panel is doing the work of what the photo detector is doing, and LED is cover the range is little bit smaller, but laser light the not cover the range distance. It's cover more distance. So that is a difference. So we can enhance the two thing, not enhance, just add instead of using LED and the photo detector, you can use it solar panel and laser light, then you can access it. Okay, so this is the procedures to do that. So how can I simply, I want to check it. There is lot of YouTube mini projects are available. So I'm not going to show any the new thing. So all the students maybe already know about this thing. So this is the way you can check this experiment, whether it's a proper, whether it is possible from the light, you can transfer the data or not. It's just available in so many YouTube and articles are available. Just you can do yourself, no need any much component. Just you can do yourself and you can check it, whether the light is transferring the data or not. So I will show this thing. I'm not going to show any new thing, just it's available already in the, okay. Before that, what are the applications it's used it? So I already told, underwater communications. So this application, using these applications, the underwater communication, the, like since the radio waves cannot be used underwater because these waves are strongly absorbed by the seawater within the feet of their transmission and all these things. But Li-Fi, the laser light, it's easy to send in that water. It's you can easy to transfer the data. Healthcare sector also, it's more benefitable. Internet is anywhere. That is a concept like street lamp, light of vehicles can be used. So that is a kind of applications. And safety and management, these kind of things, traffic signals and street light. So all the areas and safety based, if the high secured data transmissions you need means you can use this Li-Fi. So these are all the applications you can concentrate. You can create this kind of applications using Li-Fi it's really good. So these are all the things is not much available. So this is the right time to do this kind of research, and you get a more benefit. Okay. So now I'm going to show you like how the project. That one is not a new. It's already available in YouTube. Just I will show this. You just try it in your home itself. This is the way you can check the experiment. The light is transferring data. So what I'm using here, just it's a mobile phone, then 9-volt battery, one solar panel, one speaker, then the laser diode. Laser diode also you can easily get it, even if you're not getting, if you repaired CD drive or anything from that CD drive also, you can remove yourself that laser diode. I used to check it like that. So use that laser diode itself, it's okay. Then I use one more thing is a 100 ohms resistance. Why I want to use this means the 9-volt battery and the laser capacity is less. So everybody know about that Ohm's law. So based on that Ohm's law, to find the voltage means V equal to I into R. So I is the current and R is the resistant. So based on this, we fix it that 100 ohms resistance. So using that, it's send that, it's like a capacitor, it's send that proper way to transferring the data to the laser diode. So what will happen if you connect from your mobile, one positive, one negative wire to that negative, and another one from that positive from that resistant, then another connection from another laser diode. If you connect like that, and if you play any song from your mobile, then automatically your laser light is flash. Then the laser flash, you just fix it the solar panel. So the solar panel is receiving the light, then it's transferring to the speaker, then it's really surprised you can listen the music. So without wire, laser light, it's cover that how much distance it's cover, that much distance you can fix it your solar panel, and you fix the speaker, it's really surprised you can see this from this beam. Once it's point out in the solar panel, automatically you can hear the music. So without wire, you can possible to transfer the data. So it's a mini project, it's a common project, it's available in YouTube. So based on this experiment, you can try yourself in this experiment. From this experiment, you can easy to understand that means light can transfer data. So this is the experiment. Okay, this is not a new thing. It's already available in YouTube, I'm explaining. Okay, what kind of research I did in this area? What is my novelty? What is the thing I did that? So that is I want to explain now. So what I did that, just I checked it. It's I'm going to pattern soon. I'm waiting for the grant for this. So it's a technology. So I just want to explain all of you. So I will expect more research on this area. That's why I'm going to explain. So I'm going to pattern this. I'm going to get the grant for this kind of things. So what I did this thing. So I'm getting the laser beam. From the laser beam, I fix it one prism. Just it's a glass kind of prism. I just fix it the prism in between the laser light to solar panel. So if I fix the prism, I can see that more than 6 or 8 beams reflections. More than 8 reflections I can see. Then my curiosity, what I checked it, all the 8 beams I fixed. The solar panel, I fix the speaker. Whether each reflected beams also, we will get that audio, we will get that transmission, data transmission, is it possible or not? Just I checked it for my curiosity. I really surprised all the 8 solar panels, all the 8 speakers, we can hear the voice, the audio. That means a single beam to split to reflection, all the reflection is getting the same kind of data transmission, it's really surprised. So if we want to do that client server technology in LiFi, that is also possible. That is a proof I did from my research. So what I did, I will show you now. This is my novelty. So what I did here, see the same thing, which earlier one is already available in YouTube and everywhere, but this one is not available anywhere. This is my research work, what I did. So only the changes what I did, I used this prism. Using that prism, the laser light is reflecting. I just checked for sample. So two reflections, both the reflection I fixed at a solar panel. Then I connected to the speaker. Then really surprised, both the speaker is getting a same kind of transmission, same kind of audio, same kind of noise, same kind of things we can get. It's really surprised. So single beam, we can reflect to more than eight beam. So nowadays the students are very smart, and now they can try in some other way also. If you have any different ideas or anything, if you have, you can share it to me. So that is my novelty, my research area, what I did. So I use these prisms, and the reflection is getting the many reflections. All the reflection is getting the data transmission. It's already proof. That proof I already published as an article in Springer. So this article, it's already published in Springer, that intelligent computing and innovation on data science, lecturer notes, it's published. So I'm the one of the editor for this book. So you can see that Professor Sanglang Peng, Li Hong, and Dr. Susindaran, and myself, the last one is Balaganesh. And so we are the editor of this book. So I published this article in this Springer publication, which is, it's available in that particular link. So it is a Scopus index, it's already published. So this is the thing I want to share with you. So this is the way you can share high speed data transmission. So within a second, you can receive, more than 20 to 30 GB. Even if you more formations, you can make it 100 GB within a second, I'm sure. I'm sure you can get it if you do more research on this area. So that is a thing, is the latest wireless technology I want to share with you. So that's all from my side. Okay, so what are the things we do, that whatever it is, there is a disadvantage. What kind of disadvantage it's here? Because the light is cannot go through that wall. So that is a drawback. So what is the another way to do that? Or else we can make it a single pipe, like what we are doing, the fiber optical, like that we through that some pipeline, through that we can pass that laser light, then we can avoid these kind of things to transfer many places. And also it's high secured one. So some disadvantages is there. So if you do many research on this area, we can come with a good output on that. So they cannot penetrate the wall, that is a drawback, but that one also, surely we can come with a good idea, come with a good research, then you can do much better than that. So that is a disadvantage. Okay, so summary of this thing is, the LiFi technology is near the beginning technology, which is assured to provide the higher bandwidth based on the demand. LiFi technology is more secure. High speed data transmission is possible to access wherever you need without affect the environment. Many users can access same data rate from a single laser. That is my research, what I proved. Many users can access same data rate from the single laser. So that is my research I covered. So that's all from my side. So
yeah, thank you so much, sir, for delivering such a fruitful and wonderful Igniting Mind lecture. Now, yeah, sir, it's the time to take some questions from the audience, sir. Can you please permit me to take some questions?
Yes, no problem. Just a minute, I will stop sharing that thing.
Sure. Okay, so can we have our first question? Our first question is from Mitanshu Chatterjee. He is our student of B.Tech Computer Science Honours in Artificial Intelligence. So Mitanshu, can you ask the question to sir?
A very good afternoon to all, and thank you, Dr. Bhagavisha, sir, for this wonderful session on wireless transmission through ATS technologies. Now, my question is on Li-Fi. As it told us that Li-Fi has this disadvantage that it cannot penetrate through walls. So I have this question, if we need a bulb or a light source which can have this connection. So what if there is another light source present? So will there be a data loss if we have this another data source interfering the Li-Fi path?
Sorry, the light cannot penetrate to the wall. So what is the another way you are asking, or another person can access? What you are asking?
No, sir. I'm saying if you are having this Li-Fi source, let's say we have a bulb, which is our Li-Fi source. And in between, we add another light source. Let's say if a sunlight or any other light source is there. Will there be a data loss to it?
That one is not affected, but it's a good question. It will happen some noise. It will happen some noise. If you use that LED light, if we use that less, the frequency and other thing is different, then it will not much noise and all this thing. That is a really good question, because if it is sunlight and all this thing, you can get that internet access, it's not a problem. But the thing is, you will get a little bit noise, but using that laser method, not that much noise not getting. So that is, it's under the research. So these kind of things, what you are mentioned, it's a good thing. So we can do the many such kind of articles related to that, how to avoid the noise and all these things. If you use that laser light, 100% sure, you're not getting that much noise. If you use LED, surely you will get a noise if it is another light. If it is another light, it's not getting much noise, because that light is not having a data, but our light having the data. So that light is not affected. When it's affected, if the sunlight means that time it will affect it. If another light is there, still that power capacity will increase automatically. That one also you can get it.
Thank you, sir. And but what happens if both the sources are having
some data? I will give you one more example. One kind of flow of water. You are already passing the current to the water. Then you are transferring another water from another path. So if all the water is joined together, what will happen? Both water having the power is a current, isn't it?
Yeah.
Isn't it? So that time it's not given a much noise. The thing is, when it's getting much noise, sunlight, that time you receive much noise.
And so what happens if both the sources are having some data, like we both the light sources are a Li-Fi source and both are transmitting data? What will happen if they interfere to each other? Will there be a data loss, or we will have some attenuation?
No, we need to do some attenuation.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. One more question is coming from audience. As we are having our...
Yeah, please.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, there is, sir.
Yeah, sir, one more question is coming from audience. As we are having some specialization like artificial intelligence and machine learning, so some students are asking like that, can we integrate artificial intelligence into wireless communication in some way?
100%. Artificial intelligence, it's really helpful. This one is really helpful, because artificial intelligence and machine learning is kind of things, this data transmission and reflections, all these things. Nowadays, many of the thing is using like sensor-based detections and all these things. It's really helpful, this thing.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much. So is there any other question from the audience side? Yes, ma'am. Dr. Vandana, ma'am. Want to
Dr.
ask Vandana, ma'am, please.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hello. Sir, thanks for this wonderful session you have shared with us. I just want to know from the research prospective view that what are the major challenges as a researcher we are facing in LIFI, because we have to make LIFI more compatible or more useful to the layman person. So what kind of research is going on in this field?
Yes. That thing, many of them, what they are mentioning, laser light having some side effects.
Okay.
They told, then how can we use in medical and all these things? So medical line, already we are using many of the treatment and all these things, the laser is, we are already started, we used. So that laser one is not making a side effect based on the frequency, high frequency. And normally our CD laser light is very less frequent. Covered. So like the power is increased, then it's affected the eye and all these things. So this one, it's not much high power, high range, no need high range for that. If you use that less level range using the laser, you can get it easy to high data transmission. So the research in LIFI, what are the drawbacks means? Earlier days, what they are thinking, photo detector, how we can get it, and transmission, what I want to do, how that internet we want to transfer first to the light. So these are the some drawbacks they are facing in that research area. So what I given this mini project, you can get this idea. So if it is possible from the mobile, that audio is transferring from that laser, so you can, I'm not spending much money, just I spend just a solar panel is 7 ringgit. 7 ringgit means India cost is around 100 rupees solar panel. Then 9 volt battery is just, it's around 50 to 70 rupees. I am not spend more than 200 rupees or to 500 rupees. So that that is the only thing I used it, the prism and all this thing. I tried it. It's come out well. So for this LIFI technology, the component, many of the things you need to check on all these things, the component and the research area and research workshops and what are the kind of articles we want to go to that. So these are all the things we are facing some problems. But this this LIFI not having that much issues.
Okay. I think you just want to conclude with that initial cost for this LIFI is very much high if we compare with the Wi-Fi technology. Initial cost.
Yeah, initial cost. Because suppose if you want to fix it for the auditorium or one conference hall, if you want to fix it that like initial cost is high. Why? Because now we are not having the proper research on this area. That is the reason it's happening like that. Because it's still it's not under like for example earlier LED TV is high more costly. Much nowadays it's very cheaper. So like that, if we are a researchers, we are go to that deep area, if we do more and more, surely it will come very cheaper.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for putting a light on this.
Thank you, Baladhar sir. We are having one more question from our student. So Mitanshu, can you ask please?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Baladhar sir, I had this question. Like in communication, we have this sender and receiver. So here the sender we are having is a light source. Then how will this light source determine who is our receiver over there? Like we can have solar multiple panel. Receivers.
Solar panel is the receiver.
Solar panel. But what if we are having multiple solar panels? Then we want a particular solar panel to receive a particular information. Then how will this bulb determine who is the receiver over there?
Solar panel is the receiver. Then you need a converter or an amplifier to transferring like a bit. Now I saw that one is like audio, so no need any converter or amplifier. If you want to convert like a bit or what we do like modem, analog to digital, digital to analog conversion. So like a converter, just it's a converter Arduino device, you can use it, then there you can convert it.
No, sir, but my question is that like we are having multiple solar panels over there and these solar panels are our receivers and we have this light bulb as a sender. And we want a particular, let's say we have these three solar panels, A, B, and C. So I want only the C solar panel to receive a certain information and restrict that information to A and B. So how was this light bulb determined that only if C will get that information and not the other solar panels?
Sorry, I couldn't understand this. So you were asking about what do you want to see?
So in a communication, we have the sender and receiver. And here the sender is a light bulb and the receiver, we are having a solar panel.
Yes.
That is our basic communication method. Now, like in a Wi-Fi, what we do is we have this, our devices connected over here. So when we are asking for any information, to a particular device, our information is fetched and not fetched to the other devices. For in this era, we have multiple phones.
Okay.
My other phones are not getting this particular information.
Okay.
In such a way that we have solar panels. Now, in our solar panels, and I want only one solar panel to get a particular information, and those other information should not get to the other solar panels. Then how will this light bulb, which is this light bulb, how will it determine that only this particular information or a light which is from the light fight is moving should go to this particular solar panel?
So the light fight, it's not the fully used for the whole internet connection. Light fight, I already told, it's an enhanced technology. Like, for example, one place to another place, you want to transfer that 10 GB to 20 GB within a second, that time Wi-Fi cannot. So you can transfer through the Wi-Fi from one solar panel to access from the device. From the device, you can use that normal Wi-Fi or through the port method or any other method, you can use it for further send. So this one is the enhanced technology.
So, sir, are there any more research work going upon to implement this Li-Fi
lot of research work is going on this area. So that's why I need more people to do this kind of research. It's really good for the student. It's making open the eyes for the students. It's really good for that. So now the right time to do the much research. So now you can check the article also. You cannot get that much article in this area. Why? It means it's now only it started. If you started now from this area, you can reach within a 5 year was one of the great researcher.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you so much, sir, for giving the answers in so nice way. So I think we will not take any more questions. If anybody are still having some questions, they can text me also. They can text to Dilip sir also. We will convey your questions to the sir and they will definitely solve all your queries. Okay, thank you so much.
I will send that PPT also to Dr. Dilip sir. So further, if you have anything related to this case, we will discuss. It's not one day work. It's a research-based work. We continuously do such kind of work and we are expecting many from your side also. Thanks for giving the great opportunity for me. It's a great pleasure to sharing this kind of knowledge and getting a very good questions. It's really one of the first questions. It's really make me to do some kind of research on the particular area like sunlight and other light. What you have to do. It's a good idea, good thinking, good question he is asking. So we need to do some kind of research on this area. Really helpful. So if we communicate, if you are sharing our knowledge, then only we will get more idea. It's really good. Thanks for that.
Sure, we'll be in touch.
Yeah, now I would request to Dr. Dilip Kumar Singh, sir, to express few words to thank you our today's guest speaker, Dr. D. Balaganesh, sir. Sir, please.
Yeah, so it's really a very wonderful session, sir. And so the knowledge that you share, students are enlightened with that. And thank you so much, sir. And definitely you have been a fabulous expert. And the whole session has been very interesting and informative to all of us. And for sure, we'll be delighted to listen to you in future as well. So once again, sir, on behalf of JLU and JLU School of Engineering and Technology, I thank you for giving us your precious time and igniting the mind of our young students. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Dr. Dilip. Thank you for organizing.
Okay, so sir, now before let's end up with the session, I would request to each and every participant from our side, please turn your turn on your webcam so that we can take a group photograph, which can be, you know, remain as a memory for all of us. So I request each and every participant to please turn on your webcam, please.
Dr. Vaibhav, that one you can share it to me also.
Yes, sir. Sure. We will share you also, and we will share all the snapshots which we have taken till now with you. Thank you. Guys, so please just turn on your webcam so that we can just take a group pic, please. I want more and more people in this group pic. So please just turn on your webcam.
My face is okay? Looking good?
Yes, sir. You are looking good. You always look good. Okay, so thank you so much. I request to other participants also. Okay. Just a minute. Okay, thank you so much, sir. Thank you again, sir, for being in between us within your busy schedule. Thank you so much, sir. Be looking thank forward you. For you, much more sessions from your side also, and we look a collaboration with you also, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone, for joining us. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Stay safe. Stay happy. Thank you.